enter into my heart today, and I receive you, Lord, as my personal Lord and Savior. And Father, I ask you to help me to take one day at a time, one step at a time, Lord. And Father God, help me to forget about the old things and let them be passed away, and to focus my mind upon you and my heart. And Father God, today I claim you as my Lord and Savior, and I bless your holy name. In the name of your son, Jesus, I praise you. Amen, and amen, and amen. Blessed be the name of your son, Jesus. We praise you for all things. Victory. Hallelujah.
Thank you for listening to the Holiness Preaching Broadcast. Our church phone number is area code 909-943-3543. And someone will be here from 10:30 to 11:30 today to pray for you. Be sure to tune in next week. God bless you, each and every one.
To welcome you to Holiness Preaching Broadcast. We are coming from the Paris Community Church at 277 East San Jacinto Street in Paris. Services are Sunday morning, 11 a.m., Sunday evening, 6 p.m., and Wednesday Bible study at 7 p.m. Also, Fairhaven Full Gospel Church, located at 1045 West Olive in the back building in Colton. Their service is 3 p.m. Sunday afternoon. We invite you to come be with us.
Brothers and sisters in Christ, I'd like to give us a warm welcome for Brother Robert Bishop, who is going to be ministering to you, How Great Thou Art.
Cards and letters from some of our dear listeners, which has encouraged us, so we are now going to encourage you and share with you that the Lord is your provider. He is Jehovah Jireh. Whether you have needs in spiritual, physical, or financial, He is your answer. Sharing the word of scripture with you, Isaiah 53:5 reads, "But he was wounded for our transgressions. He was bruised for our iniquities. The chastisement of our peace was upon him, and with his stripes we are healed." Father, in the name of Jesus, we give you praise, Lord, for who you are in our lives, the King of Kings and the Lord of Lords. We thank you, Father God, right now that we can come boldly upon your throne, Lord, with all of our needs, knowing that you have promised to provide our needs. Lord, we know, Father God, with the letters and the cards that we have received, that there are many, many people there that are hurting, Lord, that need healing in their body, that need to be delivered, Lord, from drugs and alcohol. Father God, we believe upon you right now, Lord, that you will reach your hand down and touch these people as we speak, Father. We know, Lord God, that you love all of your children above and beyond anything that we could ever imagine. And Lord God, we know that all these needs, Lord, can be met by just that love that you have, Lord, that no man could ever provide, but only you, Father God. We thank you, Lord God, for the healing of cancer right now in the name of Jesus, as our dear sister wrote in her letter. And Father God, we thank you, Lord, for the deliverance of the husband, Lord, and the returning home of the son and the daughter. Father, we praise you right now, Jesus, in your name, Lord, that you are our answer to all of our needs, to all situations that we find ourselves in, Lord. We give you praise, Lord God, for you alone are worthy of our praise. And Lord, right now we thank you, Lord, for this broadcast that we can just come across, Lord, to thousands and thousands of people who are hurting in their lives and hungry, Lord, for your word. And we ask you, Lord God, that you would open ears and open hearts that they may learn more and more about you. We give you praise and honor and glory, Father God, for all that you have done and for all that you are about to do. In the name of our Lord Jesus Christ, we pray. Amen.
If you need prayer for any reason, feel free to please call us at area 909-943-3543. There'll be someone here between 10:30 and 11:30 today to pray for you. If you would like to write us and let us know if you enjoy the broadcast, our mailing address is Holiness Preaching Broadcast, Post Office Box 1122, Colton, 92324.
Praise the Lord. It is a privilege for me to introduce to you Reverend Richard Chapel, God's man of the hour. He will be bringing you the anointed word of God. Take time to listen and receive what the Lord has for you. For you shall know the truth, and the truth shall set you free. Here is Reverend Richard Chapel with the word of God.
God bless you. I want to thank you for allowing me this time to come into your home, into your car, wherever you are. If ye shall know the truth, and the truth shall set you free. Stop. Don't change that station. But what I have to say to you may be the most important thing to you in your life. I bring you words of life, words of liberty in Christ Jesus. Again, I say thank you. Those of you that are listening and may have your Bibles, turn with me to St. John, the third chapter. I want to tell you about a man named Nicodemus. Verse 1. There was a man of the Pharisees named Nicodemus, a ruler of the Jews. The same came to Jesus by night and said unto him, Rabbi, we know that thou art a teacher come from God. For no man can do these miracles that thou doest except God be with him. Jesus answered and said unto him, verily, verily, I say unto thee, except a man be born again, he cannot see the kingdom of God. And that is my message to you tonight, day, that except ye be born again, ye cannot see the kingdom of God. For those things which are spiritual are spiritual, and those things which are natural are natural. And in this particular few verses that I read to you in chapter 3 of St. John, Nicodemus was a natural man. He was a very religious man, but he was not a child of God. Would it shock you to know today that you too might be a religious person, but are you a child of God? Have you experienced the new birth? Have you been born again? I am not talking about church membership. I am not talking about being religious. I'm not talking about a good set of moral codes. I am talking about being born of the water and of the Spirit, being regenerated. Hallelujah. God requires us to be born again. We must be willing to take off and to die and let that old man pass away, in order that we may be born again of the water and of the Spirit. For one thing, Nicodemus came to Jesus by night. Here was a man who knew the ways of the Jews. He was a ruler of the Jews. But yet he did not know the way to eternal life. He came to Jesus. How be it that a man who, that once he is born, can he enter the second time into his mother's womb? That was not the case. Hallelujah. For we know that which is born of the flesh is flesh, and the flesh will never change. But that which is born of the Spirit is spirit. And he that worship God must worship him in spirit and in truth. For one, the fleshly birth. When we were born into sin. For it produces the old sinful nature. In Psalms 51 and 5, it tells us, behold, I was shapen in iniquity, and in sin did my mother conceive me. Hallelujah. Also, it produces a corruptible nature. And it tells us in 2 Peter, 1 Peter 1 and 23, being born again, not of corruptible seed, but of incorruptible, by the word of God, which liveth and abideth forever. It also produces an old nature under the sentence of death. For Romans 6 and 23 tells us, for the wages of sin is death, but the gift of God is eternal life through Jesus Christ our Lord. And John 3:16 tells us, for God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten Son, that whosoever believeth in him should not perish, but have everlasting life. And again I say to you, behold the truth, and the truth shall set you free. And also in addition, it produces an old nature that makes every unsaved person a child of the devil. For in 1 John 3 and 10 tells us, in this the children of God are manifest, and the children of the devil, whosoever doeth not righteousness is not of God. Yea, then he that loveth not his brother. We must be born again if we are to see Jesus Christ. Hallelujah. Then we must be born of the water and of the Spirit. We must be willing to let the old man die. That man, that sinful man, that was born of the flesh, and to be born again of righteousness. Be holy, for the word of God says, for he is holy. There is no flesh, there is a war. And that war of the spirit and of the flesh. The flesh is constantly warring against the spirit, and the spirit against the flesh. We, hallelujah, have a choice. We have a free mind. We have a will that we can decide to let the new man live. Hallelujah. If we are willing to be born of the water and of the spirit. Hallelujah. Whosoever then in 1 John 3:9 tells us, whosoever is born of God doth not commit sin, for his seed remaineth in him, and he committeth not sin because he is born of God. If you have not fully accepted Jesus Christ as your Lord and Savior, I beg you, I implore you, to hear my words this day. Neither will education, neither will your position on your job, neither will your finances save you, neither will even your church membership. But ye must know Jesus Christ in the pardon of your sin. You must have a personal relationship with the Lord. God so loved the world, as I stated before, that he gave his son Jesus Christ, that whosoever would believe in him should not perish, but have everlasting life. He gave us his son, he gave us the blood, and he gave us the Holy Spirit with the seal of redemption. Hallelujah. Praise the name of Jesus. If you have just been a church member, if you have been bumping along in life, not knowing what is right and what is wrong, I implore you to take this time to say, Lord, I need you. I need you. I want to be saved. And I implore you to come into my life and to make a change. No, I'm not talking about, hallelujah, a good set of morals. I'm talking about a personal relationship with Christ. Your pastor cannot save you. Even your church cannot save you. It can point you in the direction, but you alone must make that decision to serve the Lord. As Jesus told Nicodemus, ye must be born again. We must be willing to die and to turn away from sin and put our hands in the hands of Jesus. We must be willing to fight the good fight of faith, to stand and to endure and run the race that is not given to the swift nor to the strong, but to he that endureth to the end. For God has only one mediator between God and man, none other.
From the Paris Community Church at 277 East San Jacinto Street in Paris. Services are Sunday morning, 11 a.m., Sunday evening, 6 p.m., and Wednesday Bible study at 7 p.m. Also, Fairhaven Full Gospel Church, located at 1045 West Olive in the back building in Colton. Their service is 3 p.m. Sunday afternoon. We invite you to come be with us.
This is Evangelist Phoebe Denning, and at this time I'd like to introduce to you my daughter, little Miss Jay Denning, who is 4 years old. As I play the music, she will be singing, We've Got the Power. And trust me, she will bless your heart, and she does have the power.
Heavenly Father, I come to you in the name of Jesus. I ask you to bless your holy word as it goes out over the airwaves to people that are hurting in their spirits, their mind, and their bodies. I ask you to heal people from the top of their head to the soles of their feet, according to 1 Peter 2:24, that says, by the stripes of Jesus, we are healed. Please provide the finances that people need according to your word in Philippians 4:19 that says, my God shall provide all your needs according to his riches and glory by Christ Jesus. If there is anyone who does not know Jesus as Savior and Lord, just pray this prayer with me now. Heavenly Father, I come to you in Jesus' name. Your word says, whosoever shall call upon the name of the Lord shall be saved. That's Acts 2:21. Come into my heart, Lord Jesus. Be my Savior and be my Lord. According to Romans 10:9-10, which says, if thou shalt confess with thy mouth the Lord Jesus, and shalt believe in thine heart that God hath raised him from the dead, thou shalt be saved. I confess that Jesus is the Lord, and I believe with my heart that God raised him from the dead. Thank you, Father.